Unmarkable. Check for the mark.
Okay.
Jesus, Rick.
What were you saying about the...
There he goes. Bounced off the boat.
You started to say about the early video?
The Bat Out of Hell and the Paradise video were the first videos...
Whoa! Me!
Holy smoke. I can't talk. Wait.
What do you got? Nothing.
No, it was almost pulled the rod in.
Oh. Mine?
They were the first videos that actually proved that you could sell records through videos, because we never went to Europe, and on the strength of just like Paradise by the Dashboard Light, shown one time in Holland, it went to number one, and we sold about 750,000 albums in Holland, which is the world's record for Holland. The highest before that was a Blondie record, which was about 234,000. And we sold in England from them. But England has always sold through their videos, but Top of the Pops is like real thing. So MTV like is the first thing that America's had that is actually showing that you can sell records by video. Before, the Europeans, the Australians, people like that, the rock and roll market, that's strictly how they got people like me, Van Halen, Blondie. Anybody that they saw first was through the videos, and they show them on a lot of different kinds of shows over there. And so MTV now is doing the same thing that Europe and the continent and Australia and Japan have been doing for years.
Sure.
So, I think...
What year was that came out?
That's 77.
77.
And it hit, on the strength of that. I mean, the European market, we did, 5-6 million albums in Europe and Australia and in Canada on the strength. They had a special on my videos in Canada that was rated number 3 for the year in national television ratings from the videos. So they, after that, people wanted to know, well, what did you do and what was your, what did you do? I said, I didn't do anything. I mean, they shot it and they did it. I said, it's a matter of, when you shoot a video and you're on a stage, it's a different thing than shooting a live concert. You set them up different, you set the cameras at different angles, because when you're shooting a live concert, you got to deal with the white lights in the audience, and you got to deal with where the cameras can go and where they can't go, because it's a live performance. But when you do the videos, you set them up that way, then you're shooting a live situation and not a live show, which is a totally different area. And it's also a lot of bands that you've seen, they're not so much anymore, but they get real uptight in front of a camera, and they say, well, I'm not doing, this is not what I do. I'm a musician. I play guitar or I sing. And but it's where the marketplace is. There's a Minute Work. I mean, I think that's a perfect example. I think MTV now there's going to be competition for MTV naturally, but they were the founders. But they are in competition now with the radio stations, because the radio would like refuse to play certain things and do certain things. And MTV comes along, and they're playing things and showing you things that radio isn't. And meanwhile, Men at Work should thank MTV a lot. I think they broke that,
A lot of bands.
Oh, a lot of bands,
League,
Human League. And I'll tell you what, they even, I'm a big fan of Billy Joel, and as good as he is and as good a writer as he is, they really helped break a nylon curtain. Of course, you can't argue about his videos. His videos are some of the best. The guy, he shot those in England, and they're really like super, super things. So you're going to get into and get out of the guys who there's a big boat coming right at us, and I really don't like this. But you're going to get out of the thing of the guys a few years ago who had rich fathers who got video equipment and said, I'm in the video business. And you got to go to real film people and real artistic people, and not people that just kind of hang on to a camera and say, okay, this is great.
The people that were producing...
There's a lot of... There's going to be... you got the film schools in UCLA, and you got the people who are working different things that are going to be creative and artistic and go into the whole thing. And
Devo's a classic example of that. They're all film graduates.
Yeah, UCLA. I mean, yeah, so...
Leslie's got one.
We got good fishing.
Say hi to Barry.
And we got a big wake. Hold on. Hey.
Yes.
Knack. Yeah.
name of the album is? Have you come up with a title?
Yeah, Midnight at the Lost and Found. We've tried. Rick came up. Rick was saying, well, because it's the name of a song. Rick says, I hate to name albums after songs, you know. Bob, what are you doing? Bob's over here playing with this fish here. He says, I hate to name albums after songs because then the song takes so much on to it, you know.
Yeah.
Here, let me get this fish out of here. Bob cannot deal with the fish. Bye, fish. So, but I can't. The Midnight, the Lost and Found fits so well with the record that I can't really argue with it. And so I guess that's the title. And everybody seems to really like it, you know. I've been playing with it, though, for about 7 months. So after 7 months, you sort of want to say, well, maybe I can think of something different. He came up with, I'm hungry and
beefed up.
All these silly things.
We beefed him up this time. We gave him some power rock guitars.
Power rock guitars by Rick Derringer. So,
but
Midnight at the Lost and Found is it. And that's one of the songs.
What are your plans to for video on this album? What songs are going to lend themselves to visuals?
All of them. They always do. All the songs that we've ever done, because the way I perceive things, it's like I perceive songs, each one is a movie, or I create images when I go to sing them or whatever. Like Bat Out of Hell, for example, the image was of a Hitchcock. I mean, it was really a Hitchcock thing when I was singing. So, I mean, I got a 10-minute film whenever I sing that song going through my head, and you start out in the valley, and you pan down into this thing, and there's a fire over here, and there's blazing over here, and there's a...
That album art.
Yeah, well, that's part of the thing. You know, they put that on this religious thing the other day about the thing being an evil cover. Actually, that guy on that bike was a hero. He was a good guy, and he was breaking loose of the spell of the evil. He was a heroic figure instead of an evil figure.
I felt that.
Yeah, well, you know, these religious guys, man, you know, $700 and, you know, you're saved, Jack.
Sure.
But I'm nothing personal against people who are religious and believe in God, but these guys are ripping people off.
Sure,
what can
sure.
I tell you?
Yeah, right.
That's so, it's got nothing to do with what we were talking about either, but they're visual. You know, all the songs are visual, so they all lend themselves to being visual.
We talked to a lot of bands about their approach to video, and they all seem to take, well, a lot like you said, well, we're musicians, not actors, and they take a very passive role. You seem to want to work close with the director on your video.
Like A Dead Ringer for Love that I did with Cher, that video, that was my... I try to conceive them as much as possible, but I'm not a script writer, and I'm not a film, and I don't know how to run a camera, so... I try to get conceptions and try to get these people to understand the conceptions and let the people that are smarter than me about what they're doing take over and do it and not try to rule the, you know, roost here. You got the conception. Great. Go for it. A little fish just jumped. And, you know, let the guys who know, let the cameraman, because he knows how to run a camera. I don't. Let the director who's used to doing that do it. Just try to get, you know, your conception into them. And that's always seemed to work for me. That worked on Paradise. That worked on... You know, because I generally work with the cameraman fairly well. Because
sure.
I had him laying under, for Paradise, I kept saying, I want to shoot at angles. I want to shoot everything at angles, nothing straight on like you would watch it at a concert. That's another argument people always had. Well, if you do videos in the concert thing.
Oh, look at this one. Hey,
what
this
are
is
these
a different,
little fish? These are the different fish we've been pulling.
That's
oh,
a
we've
great
been,
one. Whatever
yeah, we've been pulling different fish in. They're a little, because we're sort of in the tropics. They're a little. Ow, shit. Oh, you sucker. Yeah, he got me. Cool it!
You're not allowed to say that on TV.
Thank you.
Well, he is a pretty fish, though.
Yeah, he's a little tropical fish.
We've got a couple
fish.
Of those today. They're blue stripes on them.
Yeah, they're little tropical fish.
I wish I knew what they are.
Do you want me to do this? If you hold it?
A little tropical fish. Oh. And he's got nine. Look at his teeth.
Let me see his teeth.
See, can you get his teeth?
Look.
Can,
hold on 1 second.
His teeth are inside of him.
Yeah, his teeth are real. Can you see his teeth?
Oh, yeah.
Got lots of little teeth in there. Here, you want to bite? We doggies.
Here, I'll hold them down.
No, it's okay. Tommy's always
I like to play with him.
You like to play with him? Boy, he's got caught by his eye.